You can switch the channels, you can video surf, but you come back cause there's no place like home turf.
We're back and headed for the Fillmore District in San Francisco to meet a young man with a lot of black pride and community spirit. Teron Jones is a young journalist who covers his turf.
Anyone in this world is qualified to voice their opinion, you know, and I'm just another person in this world.
At 18, Teron Jones is busier than most guys his age. He just graduated from Washington High School in San Francisco, and he's already found time to become a freelance reporter for the Oakland Tribune, write a column for the Sun Reporter, do some public speaking, hold down an office job at Granny's Movers, and still go on to college. Teron is in effect.
I had a story on, you know, South African kids, an argumentative brief on the youth, and I want to sing a poem. I might have some pictures with it later on.
Well, what's the nature of an argumentative brief?
It's just about...
How did you get into journalism?
It was funny, because I was volunteering for a Democratic headquarters and for Alan Cranston. I was working on his campaign. Then Jesse Jackson came up with his quest to be president. I worked on his campaign. And I met the editor of the Sun Reporter, one of the editors of the lifestyle section, Clarence Gatson. And he's all, you know, how you doing? And I was just talking to him, and he's all, he's looking for a youth editor. And I was like, well, you know, I could do it.
When you told Clarence you could do it, you didn't have any experience, right?
Well, I was good in speech. I was always, I went to the state finals 2 years in a row, and I competed in a lot of tournaments like Stanford and stuff. And I knew if you could speak, someone told me you could write. And my English teachers always said I could write. I like to meet people. I was just interested in it. Why not?
Were you nervous or at first or scared or did it?
No, I was pretty excited to get my picture in the paper, you know, and stuff like that. But then after a little while, it just becomes a thing, you know, and it wasn't as exciting. It was more of trying to get the right stories, showing both sides, you know, trying not to make my pieces as editorial as they have been in the past.
Teron wasn't always this serious. He used to have a D-minus average, and his friends called him Trenchcoat Teron because he always hid beer cans in his pockets. But when people he looked up to challenged him, his GPA jumped to A-minus.
Do you feel pressure? Do you feel any kind of forces from your friends about, you know, you're changing your lifestyle and getting so serious?
Yeah, I feel pressure, you know, and I feel that in my own way, and some of the dreams I've had, I feel that I have a destiny and that I must fulfill it, you know, in order to make me feel satisfied, you know. I've become serious, but I think that it's time for me to become serious about what's going on, because what's going on is serious.
Spends a lot of his time at the Sun Reporter, researching stories, writing, and picking up tips from his editors.
Being as it is a commentary, and that it's not, and that it's not appearing on the editorial page, this would have to be clearly labeled as a commentary.
Okay, so you're going to put an editor's note on there for me?
Why not run this as your Black Youth Perspective column this week?
I like to speak. I like to tell people where we're coming from, because it seems like there's not one youth besides rappers that are speaking out on the issues today.
Teron Jones is doing the right thing. And a lot of young people these days are worried about staying off the streets, staying off drugs, and staying in the positive. One good way to accomplish all of those things is to choose a career and get job training. If you're willing to try something new, youth in aviation may be for you.
Plane is a dream for a lot of kids, but this is a hobby for rich kids, right? Not so anymore. Sudan and Shandu are part of a group called the International Youth in Aviation Club.
It's to raise money for scholarships for low and no income youth to get into the field of aviation, which they usually couldn't afford.
We're trying to get the ones who don't have that money, where they their parents can just go buy them a plane and buy them an instructor. So it costs $25 a year to get in, and if they have their parents do not have that money, they have to work for International Youth and Aviation Club, or somehow gain the money themselves, maybe by washing planes, which you get paid about $75 a plane.
Shandu is 16 and Sudan is 12, young even for student pilots. But this brother and sister team have a lot of flying hours under their belts. Starting out was the toughest part.
I was scared to death the first time I took the introduction flight. And Shandu said it was fun and why don't you just go up? And so I went up. And I didn't want to go back up after I landed, but I decided to take lessons so I wouldn't be so afraid, because I don't like being afraid of things. And then I decided, yeah, that's what I want to do.
Most teens turning 16 rush down to get a driver's license, borrow a car, and take their friends for a ride.
Well, a lot of my friends like to go up with me a lot. You know, you could say bum flights off me sometimes.
What's the feeling that you get when you're flying?
It's a feeling of freedom, really. I mean, when you're flying, you can do just about anything you want to with yourself, you know, which includes killing yourself, which I don't intend to do.
These young pilots are trying to raise money to pay for a cross-country adventure in the air. They plan to make 17 stops on the way to spread their message to other city youth. Their motto is, don't get high, fly.
It's a black thing, and it's our history. We must investigate to end the mystery. Because if you didn't know you finished high school, how could you go to college? And in order to progress, we've got to have the knowledge of our achievement and our contribution, our leadership and cultural evolution. Because we started math, science, and geometry pioneered. Trigonometry, Egypt is large. It is our legacy, and black is large. That's why I'm proud to be, but I can unite with the rainbow of faces. Because we're all human races, all the people created equal. Word to the mother, peace is the answer.
You know everybody's hurt.